Okay, welcome back to Penguin Vlog, day 2 of week 2. I don't know why I keep saying that. But anyway, so, first of all, Kevin can be my ghost, written by Pyman. Cut that name! I can't pronounce it. Pyman Kayla. I don't know. You can look it up. Story by Jake Ritchie. There's the name I can pronounce. Okay, so, in the Kevko Penguin Kashi, in the world they go to, they are ghosts, you know. And basically the other ghost of an in-quote comic that means that Rippin and Larry, who are ghost exterminators, must get rid of, and they had to protect him. Protect him, essentially. Well, I find interesting about the ghost, but we'll go on interesting about the ghost, but I find interesting that, if you think me backwards, they have, like, if you're having to get rid of, like, an evil ghost or something that is, I've been said it kind of backward where, Rippin and Larry are exterminated. But anyway, speaking of which, the company could actually be more focused on them. Actually, start with them, and then Boone, because they're still there, still good. I think both three get equal amount of attention in the company code, and I think Kashi gets slightly more funny lying at least. When she tried to, serving Go Cabaret her from, taking care of me, Johnny when he took her off. Go that, that's interesting. But yeah, the King of Never Up could have more focused on Rip and Larry. And it kind of put in quite Nick and Nitu, but I think it kind of freshened the habit, especially against the whole crap we have going wrong around them. But, first thing to point out that there are actually no Ghostbusters graphics in Comparing Elite. No explicit ones. Like, no more than you might expect to see. No one gets kind of. If I could say, Kimmy's video happened to be a Ghostbusters related thing. So, like, that gets kind of actually lined up. But more Shining referencing with the girl I appear in one part of many cornflake references or Johnny line. More referencing there in a whole. Well, tell one that, like, why. But all that aside, this one was really good, and I really liked this one. For one, it was really funny. Like, actually, it was pretty. There was a lot of good jokes for goat thing, and a lot of good things with the goat in general. Pemagashi, they're goats, so we get to do silly thing. Gunny being a comic who gets into comic, actually really funny. Kind of cheeky, but pretty funny. I believe he is voiced by natural comedian, I don't remember his name, but I think the great version on Twitter that we got from before ago. Definitely good at it, Again, joking kind of cheeky, but it is pretty funny. And they don't go into the gym and the thing because they're just silly jokes, and they're pretty funny, and the only really cool people who are who after took a car driven Larry, but not like that. My favorite joke when big at one point he because Larry actually likes his stick, he basically gives him a stand up routine, and then Larry laughs so hard, they basically die go laughter, but then he can go back to life like after. The timing on that was really good. We can find it back, but when he died, I thought, but I'll be dead, and that's about to be up, but nope. But that was really funny. Yeah, that did make me laugh. And Larry's laughing a lot during that, and now getting contagious. that's good. The only complaint I could probably have about one is that don't pack in a lot. It got for longer than it was. In a good way, converting quite a bit to take in because of a lot of jokes and a lot of story because there he ain't Bonnie was funny because he finds kids and cool stuff. Torgon's really funny. And it's funny that the first time someone actually got that you can laugh at yourself. And like actually complete stuff in the cup of code, especially at the end. I'm not gonna spoil it, but kind of really nice ending. With Larry, stuff like that. I was not betting. I was not betting anything kind of emotional. I bet it'd be a silly episode about ghosts, but this one was really good. Like, a lot of really funny silly stuff, a lot of funny comedy stuff, cool work stuff, when like referencing a really interesting focus on Rip and Larry. Again, more of a focus on them turn around. With what we are, they do get I have equal amount of Boom could do a lot fewer funny life than Penn does, I feel like. Because Boom, when they first get there, Boom, they go, fairly funny, Goku, like, yeah, you're a Goku, you are too, you know. And it's not here, quite get down. You know, I think I remember more like Boom Cost and Penn and Goku could go. And Goku could burn out Ripping in general, so. Again, the only complaint I could really have is that dangling a little too much there, but I feel like it works so well. You know, and it's sort of a problem someone could poke Hogan in terms of some of the story element, but I think it does work really, really well. Go, yeah, it was definitely one of the best things so far, I think. Because, I don't know, it was frighteningly funny. Even though, like, I think it worked pretty well, and I was kind of nice, ending to it. So, yeah. Definitely from the bond this one. So, that I'll see you in a second for this one. Okay, and now for the chinchilla written by Kenny Burley. Okay, slowly, slight and unpalatable. Okay, go. And the code, basically, Pentagon Uncle Bam for chinchilla. And Penn is taking care of the chinchilla while they are out, and chinchilla is making life hell, and then he can get away from that during his mission, but chinchilla really dove away and become a medic when they get back to Plushy World. Yeah, another Kegel episode. So, I do not have a lot to give out this one. Relatively typical, but enjoyable. The chinchilla stuff is kind of what you would expect, you know. Until doing stuff, until Ben kind of realized that she was like a regen for doing what he's doing. Eventually, Chuck and Rogue, I believe her name was, taking control of his life and so kind of acting out because of how restricted he feels. And then Ben kind of gets that and they start to bond a bit. And there you go. You know, not a great story, but I thought they make up for it because of 9-2. Actually, you know, get some kind of element, even if Penn had to play all of it. Honestly, what Penn said, I couldn't even really infer. Like, a little bit, but he had to play everything, and I don't know if that's playing or not, but, yeah, but the chill stuff is fine. I like one more for the comedy, but there's some funny stuff to do with the chinchilla. You know, like, he beatboxing, apparently. And get back in Plushy World and do some more fun stuff for that. Yeah, I think we're going to pile up. Yeah, but again, continue to, I think we're allowed to do a few. But, again, and like in the original episode, my favorite part, I believe all the jokes with the baby Ripping and Larry. The toddler Ripping and Larry, even funnier. They do a lot of good jokes about how their limited speech, yeah. You know, now they play with, you know, like at one point, Boone gets jumped because Kakashi being played with more. that's funny. Yo. No one been conscious of flying to Kai, but I think that again that becomes a focus, that's fine. Back to chill and again they get that good joke there, go. But yeah. It took too well because I forgot for a little bit of one because I find that one funnier. But yeah, I'm not sure what to really say. Not a lot to really analyze. I think the only real thing I can offer is the fact that, yeah, you can't, yeah, they do complain a little too much of a chill thing. I feel like better if I give to them, you know, not have Penn basically explain everything about it. Yeah, but, you know, that's not bad. It can totally fine and it's perfectly enjoyable. So, yeah, it's good. It's not a lot to get good, make it enjoyable and got some nice stuff to it. And chill is fun. Go. They're not really a whole lot. Yeah, I had quite a bit of computer game because it was so good. This one, good. That was like a really, but it can have knowledge I can say everything. Yeah, that was fun. That fun little episode. You know, I think that's fine to have sometimes. Not every episode can be amazing. Yeah, it was like a fun little episode. So, yeah, but I'll go for this one. Tomorrow we have the Kobayashi and Serial Fugitive. Well, I already know one sequel. They both sound really good. Go, I shall see you tomorrow for that. Go, overall, we had an episode that was really good, really funny, really nice, and an episode that pretty funny and kind of nice. Both have Queen and Queen, but one of the cap got queener and a lot funnier. So we got one episode that was pretty great, one that good. But again, that's fine sometimes. So, yeah, hopefully it was shorter than the last few, and I shall see you tomorrow for the next episode. Goodbye.